back to BYU Football Media Day. Jason Shepherd with you and joined by a couple of Nacua brothers, Samson and Puka. Nacua joining me here on the second floor. Guys, thanks for doing this. I appreciate it.
Wasabi warrior out here.
So now you get this is the first time that you're doing something of, is, correct me if I'm wrong, officially as BYU Cougars, is that correct?
Yeah, indeed so.
We Cougs now.
So what's so different about it? Just take me through what this has been like, because this has got to be pretty crazy, especially for you having come from Utah.
Just the blue. I think the blue is the biggest difference, honestly, just wearing blue. I've never been a big blue fan. Not like BYU, but like just blue.
Just the color blue in general.
Yeah, the color blue, but now being in the color blues, you know, it's cool, honestly. I like it. My mom says I look better in blue, so I'm like, all right. So
it made you more handsome. Is that what mom says?
Fresh haircut, cleaned up the beard a little bit. She's like, you look good. I was like, heck yeah.
What about you, Puka? You've been doing the Shaka Wise for like the last 5 minutes. You're pumped.
Yeah, no, I got my nails done. I'm set. I've been all about it. Ever since I seen Kalani, the double Wise is the way to go. He does it the flip line. I think I got to come here for it. Yeah. I'm all about it.
Well, take me through what this offseason has been like. Because, I mean, obviously, it's not like anything major or anything, you know, different has happened to you guys in the last little while. I'm sure it's just been, you know, as normal as possible, right? What's the last couple of months been like? Because it's been nuts.
Yeah, it's definitely been pretty nuts, but it's been nice to come back home and to be able to be around our family, and then getting to know all the guys here on the team. It's been a lot, but it's been so fun in the experience of getting to know everybody and just getting back into workouts, and then obviously preparing for season, but being around home, and I've missed Utah. I mean, Washington's got mountains, but not right here. Like, in my backyard, every time I wake up, I see the Y around the mountain. I'm like, man, it's nice to be home for sure.
What has it meant to you? You talked about how strange it is to be wearing the blue. And what has it meant to you to be wearing BYU gear and colors now and to be representing this university now?
Family and tradition. I mean, that's the biggest thing here. And I think that's a big reason me and Puka came back is family. And then the tradition here, the culture they hold. My brother Kai was here and he talked about it and how he loved it here and his experiences. And I think that just helped bring us back home, the big family, and then Kalani and the team getting to know everyone. It's such a great environment here. Everyone's vibing with each other, talking, going to hang out, going to do stuff together, family home evening together. We're all doing it. Yeah.
How is Kai doing, by the way, with the 49ers? Yeah. How's he doing?
He's doing pretty good. I mean, he doesn't want to go up against us, but for the most part, he's doing pretty well over there.
Who wins that battle, by the way?
I mean, that's information that won't benefit if anybody.
Because all three of you are going to say you're going to win, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Well, that's a brother thing, right? Yeah.
I mean, I'm the youngest, so I learned all the tricks and stuff, so I feel like I've definitely taken the upper hand in
I got
this situation.
I still got some up my sleeve. You don't got them all.
He's taught you a lot of things. He hasn't taught you everything.
Yeah, facts. I can't.
All right, so Puka, I want to ask you this, because when you were on BYU Sports Nation before, we had asked you about your eligibility, because there was some pause as to maybe whether or not you were going to be able to play this year or not. You said, I'm hopeful that I'm going to be able to play, but it sounds like everything's a go now, right?
Yep, cleared to go. Be ready for September 4th in Las Vegas.
How exciting was that when you got the news? Because obviously being here around the team and around your brother and everything, that would be awesome even if you didn't get to play. Yeah. But the fact that you get to be on the field, what did that mean to you?
It was huge. Like, it was such a moment of excitement and then a relief as well, knowing that, like, okay, now everything that I've been working up for is going to pay off. Like, I'll be ready to go for season, and then when it's time to lace them up, we'll be ready to go.
I want you to describe his game, and I want you to describe his game.
Puka's game?
What makes each other a good receiver?
I think the biggest thing about Puka is his confidence and, like, him just always believing in himself and that he can dominate no matter what and no matter what situation he's put in. My confidence is definitely not as high as his, but, like, I'm still working towards it. But Puka is so confident that he's not scared of anyone. He's down to go against Kai, any NFL player, and he'll, I think, exceed. And that's the biggest thing. And he's smart. His smartness, his wit for the game is just unreal. Like, he doesn't study the game like anyone else I know. And he's just really in tune with the game and himself, honestly. So that's really good.
All right, Puka, what about Samson?
There's so much. I think a lot of Samson's football skills come from off the field. The way, if you know Samson, the way he interacts with people and the energy that he brings and carries with himself all the time translate directly into his football game. He's so free and so loose all the time that it's just a natural flow for him. Like, when he had his long hair, obviously, there's a little bit more flow to it. He had his crazy hair and stuff, but just the relaxness. It's not I wouldn't use the word direct, but it's the calmness and the smoothness of it all is something that I've always tried to put into my game, because mine's always so much more abrupt, more like aggressive, but there's such a flow to his game that it just makes watching the receiver run the routes and catch the ball, it's art for sure.
Well, you've mentioned it, both of you have mentioned it in this interview. You've mentioned it in almost every interview I've heard from both of you in terms of why you came here, and it was family. Be able to have that. So have you guys taken a second to think about what that moment's going to be like when you realize you're both playing on the field in Provo and your family's here to see both of you play like that?
No, not yet. We had an event in the stadium the other day, and they're still doing kind of the renovations for the screen and stuff, but to kind of walk barefoot on the grass, and that was kind of the only moment I've been able to kind of at least take in a little bit of it. Just imagine 65,000 roaring in Lavelle Edwards Stadium, and then look to my left and look to my right and see the guys that I've been working with all, and then look a little bit closer, and the guy I grew up with my entire life is right there next to me, and we get to do what we love and play football together, and then look to the sideline. Hopefully after the game, my mom got me a cougar tail waiting for me, so it'll be nice.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just excited. I don't know if it's hitting me yet, but like just being back home, and like me and him grew up playing football together. We were on the same peewee football team, and it was awesome. And then we took our own separate ways in high school, and did a little bit of our own in college too. But just to be back to like our stomping grounds, being back together, I think it's going to be amazing, honestly. And being back with him, I mean, whether we're playing any sport, when we play together, I think we just elevate each other's games. So it's going to be honestly amazing.
So you mentioned that you guys played together growing up and then kind of went your separate ways, two different high schools. But there obviously was one big matchup between your two schools. Would you like to tell that story?
No.
I won.
Okay.
I won. It was
because it's a great story.
I could probably do so. We were winning a majority of the game. Orem, you know how we do, like four-time state champs. Let me put that out there. You know, represent one Tigers.
You know what we do. All right.
But we were up the whole game, and they had a quarterback, and for some reason they subbed this guy in the middle, like right before halftime, and we have him sacked like 12 yards deep. He spins out of it, out of nowhere, like looking like he's freaking like Madden or something, looking down the field, like points to the receiver at the end zone, launches like a 70-yard bomb, and it's his touchdown, and then it's right in front of our student section, just like takes off his helmet, starts screaming at us. I'm like, man, I hate that guy. And at the same time, I'm like, that's my brother. I've seen him do it before. But I was really mad that we lost. Like, I still don't forget that. Like, it gets me riled up. Like, when I want to go work out, I'm like, man, we lost to TimView my freshman year.
And were you originally the quarterback?
I was more of like the left bench, but they needed me, and I was like, all right, I got you, coach. I can do this.
So this obviously, you know, with family and everything, it's such a great story. But in terms of actually on the field, obviously you two coming into this receiving core and this offense, every BYU fan's eyes light up. They get a huge smile on their face. What do you guys feel like you bring to the offense, and just your overall thoughts on what this offense is capable of?
I think the sky's the limit. I'm so excited for us being able to watch how the offense worked last year with the guys that they had, and then having Neil and Gunner come back into the receiver room, two guys who have already been there and kind of set the tone for how the receiver room is supposed to be run. And it's already, there's been a tradition to have those guys here at BYU are in the receiver room, but this year we got more guys than I think we've ever had before. So we have a great opportunity in front of us to kind of showcase our skills that we got, but I'm excited. I feel like all our receivers, we play such a different game, but with the way football is changing and we want to throw the ball, I feel like we fit right in.
Honestly, it's going to be a perfect fit for us. The offense is already explosive, and we're just happy to be able to join this team. And then you having Neil and Gunner lead the receiver group, and then us just help in any way we can. It's going to be great, honestly.
Yeah.
And the offense has been killing it, and we just want to show that there's not going to be any drop-off since people left. That we're going to be still the same team like last year, like, or even better. Like, that's what we plan to do.
You know, beyond just obviously the coaches wanting you to come here and it be, you know, the family side of things, how much of what the offense was able to do last year in that style, how much of that was appealing to you guys?
As a receiver, very, very, very,
very appealing.
That guy
seeing them throw the ball like that, oh my goodness. Like, that's every man's dream almost.
Yeah, that guy number one could sling the ball for sure, especially watching film and like learning the offense as we've been coming in, like watching Neil and Gunner, like that was pretty much watching their highlight tapes, obviously Dax too, and then just watching some of the throws that Zach would make and just the way that the offense was so confident in what they were doing and just throwing the ball, be willing to stick to the game plan that they had come out there with and kind of let it fly was super appealing to watch, definitely.
Well, and there's three quarterbacks in the mix to be the starter, and all three are more than capable of being the starting quarterback and running the offense.
Yeah.
That's got to feel great for you guys that you realize whoever ultimately wins the job, you're going to be set.
Yeah, that's a great
especially thing. For the entire offense and the team. Like, there's going to the leader who steps up is going to be a guy who we're going to be there behind, and we're going to ride till the wheels fall off, and I'm excited for it.
Realizing that there is some business to take care of, week one against Arizona first, what is week two against the University of Utah going to be like for you specifically, Samson?
Hey, I haven't even thought about it too much. I'm so locked into the first game. Back at home in Las Vegas, you know, Raiders Stadium.
Okay, like, I know what you're saying. I don't buy that first.
I'm locked into game one, and when game two comes around, we can redo this interview, and I'll let you know right there what I'm feeling.
What would it, honestly, we don't need to get into the exact number of the streak, What would that be like for you to be on the team that breaks that streak? For both of you, honestly.
It'd honestly be amazing because, you know, BYU has always been a great team. And they've had a couple years where they've fallen behind. But I think this is a year for us to do great things in whatever game and whatever team we go against. I think we're going to give them their hardest game. So whoever, whatever streak, whatever, with any team, we're going to put up a good fight.
You still getting the dirty looks and the snide comments from former teammates now that you're at BYU?
A little bit. I get a lot of DMs from fans, so it's a little hurting, but it's okay.
What was the reaction from Washington teammates when you decided to leave Seattle?
A little mixed. Majority of the guys were pretty cool, but it was honestly interesting because this was the game that we had a possibility to schedule last year with the COVID season and stuff, was that there was the thing anytime, anywhere that BYU was putting out, and we happened to miss a game, and it was like, oh, BYU's going to play Washington again, and we had played them my freshman year, so it was exciting, but it didn't end up happening. But most of the guys were pretty cool on the team about it. It's obviously hard to leave a program, but most of the guys are understanding of the situation and stuff like that.
Yeah.
All right, so I want to ask you this because it could happen in the Utah game. Now, I got to give credit to my producer, Himahe Muli. We believe that if you catch a touchdown in that game, that you would be the first BYU player to score for BYU and against the team that you transferred from. So it's not a BYU-Utah thing. We think you would be the very first one. What would something like that mean to you?
Oh, that'd be amazing, especially against your old team.
Yeah.
That's something crazy. I mean, I got a touchdown against our rivalry when a couple years back against BYU. And I mean, just for them to come down here and we score against them, you know, it'd be, I'd try to high-five the whole defense. I'm going to try to high-five my whole defense if I do.
All right, let's wrap it up with some brother questions, okay? And I'm going to ask these exact same questions to Gunnar and Baylor Romney coming up in a little bit as well.
Yeah.
Okay? All right. So, three quick questions. Who's the more bossy brother?
This guy.
Despite being the youngest.
Yes, this guy is. He's always in command and demanding everything. Because I'm more relaxed and laid back. I'm like, yeah, bro, I'll do it. I don't even care. Like, but this
we
guy.
We got a
definitely
schedule to be on. You know, time, place,
okay,
time,
so
is, time, time
it.
Is money.
Yeah.
Time
you're not
is
denying
money.
You're
no,
in.
I'm more the free flow. I'm more the free flow. He's on a set schedule, and I got to follow him.
Okay.
Today, like, yeah. I mean, he's always there to pick me up. But I mean, if we're running late, I mean, he knows we're we got to be there.
The messier brother is who?
Definitely me. Yeah. Definitely me. I'm more relaxed, so I'm just like, yeah.
Relaxed dude. Is code for messy. Is that what
yeah,
you're saying?
Facts. Okay, yeah,
exactly.
Yeah, don't look at our car.
Okay. All right, the last one. Who's the mama's boy?
That guy.
No, there was absolutely no differing on this. It was pretty unanimous.
Yeah, I love mama. Wait, don't get wrong. Yeah. I still love
my mama.
Yes.
Hey, mom, I love you. But we definitely know Puka is definitely the more mama boy.
All right, Samson, Puka, thank you so much for stopping by. This was a lot of fun. I'm glad we were able to get you on your very first official BYU interviews here at Players. Thank you so much. And I know fans, myself included, really excited to see the product on the field. And you guys are going to be a major part of it. Thanks, guys.
Thank you so much.
All right, coming up, we'll talk with Ed Lamb and Tyler Batty. That's